In this lesson, you will learn how to save Business Intelligent Report data to be compared against other data sources. Data integrity can be compromised as it's moved and transformed through the warehouse. It is important to test this filtered and aggregated data in the BI reports against the original data as it moves through the warehouse. In our use case, the BI report can be tested against the original CSV flat file, SQL Server staging and warehouse databases, as well as the Snowflake database. Using this layered approach, we can now identify when an issue occurs and avoid having to debug from the report backwards. For this lesson, we will specifically show how we can compare the report data between the SQL Server staging database to Snowflake database, and then Snowflake database to the Tableau report, as well as Power BI. To do our business intelligent report testing, we use a combination of Tosca's model-based automation for UI and API, as well as Tosca data integrity. If I open up Tosca, navigate to my BI reporting section, I've already created the modules I need for Power BI and Tableau for both UI and API. This is done using the standard scan approach for UI applications and API. As you can see, I've already created all the modules to log in and navigate to the data within Power BI, as well as Tableau. And for Tableau, I can access my data via API, which is always the recommended way. If I collapse here, we can go to our tests and let's select our Power BI test case. We are going to retrieve the data from Power BI, retrieve the data from a database, and then compare the data together. If we look at my test, I'm opening up the browser to my Power BI home, navigating to my actual report, and you can see here in this example, I'm pulling the data straight from the actual UI report. If I scroll a little further down, I'm then going to run a SQL query against the data in Snowflake, save the data, and then do a straight compare value to value from measure of death by zip from the BI report versus the MART. As you can see, if we wanted to do multiple data, multiple values, this would require a lot of additional effort to set these up with different steps. If I go to my Tableau report, this would be one more recommended way. I can still launch my Tableau instance, log in, and this time there's actually access for me to download my report data into a CSV. This is saving to my same report's location. I then go to my row by row comparison module. Because I have all my data from my report in a CSV file, this is structured, so I can then run the query against Snowflake, filter it in the exact same format, order it as well as needed, and compare the Snowflake data to my CSV file. If I select my Power BI by Tableau via API, you can see to download and retrieve the actual data is done in four simple steps: the request response to authenticate myself, and then to actually grab the data. So going via the API is always a lot faster and a lot more stable to retrieve this data for the BI reports, and always the most recommended way, but we have the other options available too. Let's run our BI report testing now. Now that my report testing has finished executing, I can go look at my results, and we'll drill down to my BI report first for Power BI, and we can check in this instance the data from the report matched the actual database. For Tableau, we saved the file as an XML, as a CSV, and then did a row-by-row comparison. What I've actually done, if I scroll through here, is I first compared the data from SQL Server to Snowflake, and then from Snowflake to the data from Tableau CSV, which was saved. So we'll have a look at those reports in a second. But you can have a look here. In one of the tests, it failed where the expected and the actual was different. where the source had 168 rows and the target had 165. Let's collapse that and have a look at our DI reports. Here we can see the actual data that was saved and the reports generated along the way. So the first one was the actual data from the Tableau report, which we saw during the execution. It just saved it as a CSV. Then it went through and did our layered approach and first compared the data from the Tableau report to Snowflake, and there was no issue over there doing a direct compare. But what you'll also see is by setting up a test from the staging database to Snowflake, we can see there was a mismatch with the actual data, where some of the data didn't make it to the actual Snowflake table. This is important because if we only tested from Snowflake to the actual data, we would have missed that along the way we actually lost some data.